Hi everyone, and welcome back to part 5 of the bunny rabbit tutorial. Sorry for the delay on this one, I'm a little bit behind with my work at the minute, so I've just been catching up on everything and now I'm all caught up. Well, kind of. I can now sit down and film the next part of this tutorial, so yes. So, as always, everything that you need to know about this tutorial is listed in the description, and if you're just joining me here and you want to start from the beginning, I'll link part 1 down below too, so go and start there. But if you're up to date, then let's just carry on and get stuck in. Okay, first things first, I'm going to dab away the pencil lines. Dab them whiskers away as well. Right, I'm going to start with the base colour, which is the buff titanium, and I'm just going to bring that down the back. And there's just like a little tufty bit here. I'm just gonna add it. I'll bring it down to about there for now. And then I'm going to use the brown ochre 10% and I'm just going to start adding a bit of that in. I'm going to add it into this tufty area first. And then I'm going to add a little bit through here, but I am going to leave some of that buff titanium showing through because it is a bit lighter there. And then starting from here, I'm just gonna start bringing it around like this. And then round here, it's sort of like a bit more like white coloured around here, so I'm going to start it from about there. And then I'm just going to keep going until it meets in the middle. You're all doing well and you've been having a nice few weeks since I last saw you. I have a vlog that I've half recorded that I need to finish off, so hopefully that'll be coming soon. I'll finish it and then get it done. I'm just going to add a little bit around here. And I'll add a little bit around here. Right, before I go any further, I'm going to add the nougat so I can more clearly see where these bits sort of, where the head ends and the body begins. So I'm just going to start mapping in some fur. With the nougat. And I'm sort of like bringing some little
pointy strokes back into this fluffy bit around the head to start defining that edge. Just very lightly building it up. Bits down here.
So there's sort of like a lighter bit around here, and then it gets a bit darker. So I am just going to add in where that is.
Just doing like little crossing over hers. Sort of like meeting in a point at the top.
There we go. And I'm just going to add a little bit more nougat, sort of coming out of this brown area.
And then I'm going to blend it through here. So it all sort of like connects in a bit of a line around there. Just add a bit more. Then I'm just going to break it up with a few little bits through here.
And I think I'm going to add a little bit of some dark cadmium yellow. It's quite yellowy toned around here, so I'm just going to really lightly just blend a bit of that through. Very, very lightly. Just want to like brighten it up a tad. Then I'm going to add some burnt ochre on top to make it more orange toned.
I'm just going to start blending that in. Just sort of like tones down that yellow a bit and makes it a bit more orangey.
Sort of like go with this orange here.
I'm just gonna keep layering it until it goes a bit more orange. And I'm gonna like blend it down a little bit into the body.
And I'm gonna add some more nougat. Needs a bit more detail in there.
Adding a little bit more definition in the fur.
And then I'm going to use the burnt umber.
And to begin with, I might just do these bits here. Make it a bit more obvious where that
lighter fur,
so it comes and meets the body. Doing my little sort of pointed shapes, like upside down V's.
But
that needs to come down here a bit more. I'll just erase that bit.
And I'll use the nougat, just
start bringing that down here.
Where this like
more white fur is.
That's better.
Might bring that bit down a bit more. I've done it a bit too high up. With the nougat, just adding some more little shapes in. And then burnt umber. So darken it up.
And I'm going to add some more nougat around here.
And I'm going to blend a bit more down here. Lighten that up a tiny bit. I definitely did that in slightly wrong place, but it doesn't matter too much. And add a bit more burnt ochre.
Then I might add a bit of Museum Aquarelle white, just
around here. make a bit more of like a white tone.
Then I'm going to use the Nougat and just carry on
doing some little hairs. Sort of like coming a bit more like sideways here.
And I'm going to add some dark sepia.
So I'm going to carry on bringing it down here.
And I'm going to add
some going down here.
Even add a bit of warm grey for.
It's quite grey through here. It's going to blend a bit through. A little bit around here. A bit more around here. Sorry if I'm a bit all over the place doing this. Because I've not done this in a few weeks, I've kind of like lost my where I'm up to with it kind of thing. I'm sure if you've stepped away from a drawing for a bit, you know what I mean.
Just trying to get back into the swing of things with it.
Add a little bit down here.
Then I'm going to carry on with the dark sepia.
Just darken it up a little bit. Add a bit more definition.
And I'm going to bring it across this sort of like line. Add a little bit more burnt umber.
Blend it in a bit better. more around here.
And I'm going to add a bit more burnt ochre. I think it needs a bit more orange.
Get down the body a bit more.
And there's like a bit of an orangey bit here. Add some dark sepia to this sort of line here now.
I'm just going to darken it up a little bit. I'm going to add a little bit more to this top bit. Just want to darken it up a tad. More sort of hairs to like blend it down a bit more,
and add a few more hairs with the warm grey 4 around here.
Blending it through.
Might add a little bit of museum aquarelle white just to
lighten it up in places.
And I'm going to add some more nougat.
And here. more of a browny colour. Sort of concentrating it to like the bit just above the dark area. Blend it in a bit better. A bit more around here. And I'm going to blend a bit more out around here. Add a little bit to this tuft. Add a bit more through with this bit. And then I'm going to start bringing some fur down. It gets very messy around here, so I'm just going to like proper cross the hairs over and make it look proper clumpy. Very strange fur texture on a rabbit. Sort of like proper just crosses over everywhere. And I'm going to add some more dark cadmium yellow.
It's very yellowy around here. Really lightly, because this is such a pigmented colour.
And then I'm going to add some burnt ochre.
More around here. and a bit more through here.
And I'm going to use some burnt umber and just start darkening up
some of these little bits of fur. So we're trying to follow the same pattern, like crossing over. And I'm going to bring it around this bit here. And I'm going to add some little hairs around here.
Gonna add some more nougat.
Almost looks a bit bluey toned around here as well.
I'll add a little bit of sepia 10%. Let's try that first. So luminance, sepia 10%. Just gonna blend a bit of that
around this sort of like back area.
And I feel like I need a bit of Payne's grey.
Just gonna do some little hair strokes with it. A slightly different colour to it than the rest of the furthest bit.
And I'm going to add a little bit of the brown ochre 10%.
Just sort of like filling this bit here. bringing it down here a bit.
I'm going to use a little bit of dark sepia as well, just to sort of blend this bit in
a little bit more. Brings it together a bit better, I think. And blend a few hairs back into this bit. And I'm going to add some dark sepia like around this area.
And I'm going to add a bit more burnt umber. And I'm going to add a little bit of dark sepia into
these bits.
Right, I'm going to start bringing it round here now. So, I'm going to use the buff titanium. And I think what I might do is... because the whiskers are so hard to see, what I'll do, I'll go in first with the base and then I'll decide how to add the whisker on at the end.
Whether it's with a slice tool or... I might try it with the white pencil. I don't know, we'll see. I'm just going to bring this all the way around here.
I'll do that edge in a little bit. I'll do this fur first. And then I'm going to use the brown ochre
to start bringing that down.
I'll just do the edge now.
Just get rid of those pencil marks.
I'm going to use the buff titanium and just do
some little hairs coming off. A little bit longer as you go down.
Oh, I feel like I just gone out of the shot. I only went a bit further down there. Did some little hairs. And gonna use the brown ochre and just
go on top of them a little bit.
Okay, I'm gonna start using the Nougat now to start mapping in the fur around here. So again,
it's very like all over the place.
So I'm just gonna like
cross it over and stuff.
Just gonna keep my eye on the picture and try and
do my best to get the same sort of look.
Then underneath the chin, there's almost like a bit of a greeny colour. So I might just blend in a little bit of olive green yellowish. Olive green yellowish, and I'm just gonna
softly add that in. Really lightly. And blend it out here.
Then I'm going to carry on with the Nougat.
Bringing that under the chin as well.
And I'm just going to blend a little bit of the dark cadmium yellow.
Just around here, very lightly again.
Then a bit of the burnt ochre. And then I'm going to use the burnt umber and start adding some more detail and definition into this fur. Proper taking my time with it. Bend it down a bit under the chin. And I'm going to use some dark sepia. A bit more around here. add a bit more nougat.
Little hairs that are coming off this right hand side.
My burnt umber. And I might just add a little bit more burnt ochre. And a little bit more around here. And I'm just going to add a bit more nougat.
Just sort of to soften off this bit here.
Bit more of the cadmium, dark cadmium yellow.
Bit more around here too.
And I'm going to add a bit more dark sepia. Okay, I might leave it there for that part now. I feel like we've got to a good point. So, yes, in the next part we'll carry on down the body and hopefully we'll make some good progress and won't be too far off finished. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this part of the video and thank you very much for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Make sure to give this video a like if you enjoyed it, subscribe to see more coloured pencil videos, and goodbye for now.